Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC670GBI002. This is a field control bus interface unit. And basically the video is going to be to show you guys how to test if you have a good working unit, how to thoroughly test it, how to use it with the handheld monitor and with Proficy Machine Edition through the Genius Bus Controller, the BEM331. Okay, so just a quick description of what I have here and what you guys should have. On the 9030 side, as I mentioned, I'm using a PWR330 power supply, a CPU374 Plus, and a Genius Bus Controller. That's the IC693 BEM331. I have it attached, incidentally, to an IC693CHS3975 slot rack. For this test, you guys are welcome to use a different processor, different rack, but you will need to have the Genius Bus Controller. Okay, and I have the Genius Bus Controller connected to my GBI through the serial A1 and A2, and I also have a shield. Okay, also there should be a resistor. Make sure that you have a resistor. I'm using a 150 ohm resistor in between A1 and A2. Okay, now this unit is a 24 volt DC unit, is what the power supply you will need to power it up. So I have my positive lead for my 24 volt DC power supply on the furthest most screw to the right, and the second to the right is my negative lead for a 24 volt DC power supply, and it's currently powered up. To the right of it I have a two slot chassis, and I happen to be using an IC670 MDL740. Now the reason that I'm using this, and you guys can use whatever device, IO device that you would like in this particular slot, or you can use two slots if you like. But what I'm trying to do is to test the GBI's ability to turn on and off the outputs of this particular module. Okay, this is an output module, a discrete output module. So if I can get the information to go from this GBI to this MDL740 and turn the outputs on and off, then I know that this is a good working unit. Okay, so first thing, of course, as you can see, I've got it powered up. I have a green LED where it says power. Yeah, if you guys don't have that, then that means the unit is would need replacement or repair. So the first thing that I want to do is actually going to be with the handheld monitor. Let's see if I can put this in the most visible way for you guys. Now, I happen to know that this particular unit is set up right now for the baud rate of 153.6K standard. Make sure that the baud rate that you're using matches the handheld monitor to the GBI and also to the BEM, which is something that I'll show you guys how to do shortly. Okay. So I'm going to select OK with that baud rate. And the first thing I'm going to want to go to is F1 handheld monitor utilities, F1 handheld monitor configuration, next, and I want to select the proper host. This handheld monitor was using a 90 series host, so we're going to go to toggle until we get to PCIM QBIM Genius and hit enter. This is the host that we're going to use for this. And we're going to go back to home, configuration, and at this point we'll program our block ID. Okay, doing my best so that you guys can see what I'm doing with this handheld monitor. What I've done is I've selected block number 1, and I'm going to show you guys where that relates in Proficy Machine Edition in just a moment. And then I'm going to hit F4 for next, just to show you guys that if you do want to change the baud rate on your particular GBI, you can do it here by hitting toggle, which is F2, and you can go through all the different available rates, right? But we're going to stick with the standard. Go back to home and configuration, F3. Now we're going to go to the configuration of block, F2 configuration, and F2 module configuration. Okay. The IO scan should be enabled. F2 to toggle to the next screen. The network should be enabled. Okay, if these things are disabled, you guys are going to have a hard time following this, so make sure that those are enabled. The input block map, we don't have an input, so there's nothing there. That's why there's a question mark. We do have an output, okay? And we're going to start it on output 00001. That's fine. But when it asks us how what the length is, we're going to put in 16 because this is a 16 output module, and we're going to hit enter. All right, and we don't have any analog input, no analog output. And do we want to accept these changes? Yes. Okay, now the next thing that I want to do is toggle the sync mode to yes, what I normally do here. And then slot number one. Okay, so we're in slot number one on the chassis right now. Okay, and I'm going to ask it to read what the module is. So I'm going to hit F4 for read, and it's telling me it's a discrete output 16. little joke in the office, it doesn't have ESP. It knows that it's an output 16 just because we told it that in the previous screen. So I'm going to hit enter and say yes it is. I'm going to hit enter one more time, which is going to give us the length of output 1 through 16, as you can see here. Now we're going to go ahead and hit zoom, and we're going to toggle using the F2 button through these screens. These are all the adjustment screens. If you want to put your output default state on or off, we're going to keep them off so we can turn them on our own. Okay, and then do we want to report faults? Yes, I always keep that on. Okay, the next thing is, once that's done, which is what we're completed on this screen, I'm going to go back through to the previous screen and hit F4 for more, F2 for previous menu, and F1 for monitor. Okay, and then F1 for monitor IO. Next thing I'm going to do is, you have left and right arrows or toggle forward or backward. We're going to go to F2, and that puts us to our output. Now I'm going to stop right there, because at this point we're able to turn on and off our outputs. So what we want to do once you're at this point is hit force, which is F3 1 enter. Okay, now I've turned on one output. Now I'll turn on a couple so you guys can see. I'm going to toggle over using F2 to the next output. I'm going to hit force, F3, 1, enter. F2 for channel output number 3, force, F3, 1, enter. Do one more. F2 to get to output number 4, F3, 1, enter. Now, I've been able to put on all these four outputs, okay? So here's what we have so far. We're able to program the GBI to tell it that there is an MDL740 on slot number 1. And then we're able to have the GBI tell the slot to turn on its outputs. Okay, so I know that that part is working. And the next thing is to make sure that it's working with Proficy Machine Edition. So I'm going to turn off those outputs by hitting F3 force, F4 unforce. And we're going to go back arrow to output number 3, force unforce. Force unforce. Force unforce. All right, now we have our outputs in the off state. All right? Now, one other thing that you guys are able to do with this, if you go to home, F2 for analyze, F4 for pulse test. There are currently no faults. This is where I would go to read if there's any current faults, but there are none. Okay, so that's your fault screen. Okay, now in Proficy Machine Edition, we want to be able to turn this run LED on. And the only way we can do that is through the Genius bus controller. That's the BEM331. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to open up my Proficy Machine Edition. I have the same physical configuration, if you're following my arrow here on the right-hand side, as I explained that I have on the rack here. Slot number 2 is where my BEM is. So I'm going to right-click, add module, go to bus controller, BEM331. And then I'm going to go over to my global data. And as I mentioned before, I made our GBI number 1. Okay, that was our address. So as far as device type, we're going to leave it as being called generic because it's not a Genius block, but it is a Genius device. Okay, so it's generic. Now if we slide over and you look at these columns here, input address, input length, input address 2, input 2 length, output 1 address, output 1 length. Now, our output address is 1, okay? That's consistent with what we have in the GBI. But our output length here needs to be changed to 16. Okay, so now our output length is 16. Incidentally, if you had a situation where, for whatever reason, you wanted to use 2 slots with your GBI to test its ability to maybe you want to put on 2 MDL740s, what you would do in that instant is output 1 length, you would call it 32, okay? And then if you put on another chassis and you put 2 more MDL740s, you would call the length 64, okay? Just a quick little note there if you didn't already know it. Now I'm going to connect up to the processor and I'm going to toggle to online mode. If you look down below, my status currently is programmer mode. It's the outputs are stopped, the processor's run mode is stopped, the outputs are disabled, configuration and logic are not equal. I'm going to go to target because those are not equal, and we're going to hit clear, controller and IO fault table so we can start fresh. And if you don't do that, you're going to get hung up when you go to do the download. We're going to do the download now and start active target. To the controller, we're going to download hardware configuration and motion and logic. Okay. And do we want to enable the outputs? Yes. Now, going back to the GBI, you will now notice that the run light is now on. Now that's necessary to make sure that you have a good working unit, because we were able to test that the GBI could take some information, hold the information, and give it to a module on the two-slot chassis here. But we didn't know whether or not it would work with a Genius bus controller. So I've been able to test now the A1 and A2 port that goes to a Genius bus controller that can also control, send information or receive information from the GBI. So now I'm certain that all of that works, okay? Now, if any of these things don't work when you do your test, if you guys are testing something in the field that you might think is troubled or broken, anything from just simply a power light not going on, or if you find a fault in the handheld monitor, as I described before, if you have a lack of communication, as you could see, when I was using the handheld monitor, I didn't have any lack of communication. I was able to communicate with the GBI and ask it to do whatever I wanted it to do with no glitches. So, and of course, if you're unable to turn on outputs or use a Genius bus controller, any of those things, which is a lot, that doesn't work with this GBI means that you have a broken GBI. You have a GBI that needs repair or replacement, okay? This is a module, the IC670GBI002, something that we very commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.